chuta utataka nitakupama.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's your girlfriend Elungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. Like I said, my name is Fanny Lungu, and on this channel we post reaction videos each and every day, so if there's something that you guys want us to react to, let us know by dropping the link in the comment section below and we'll do it for you. A big shout out to the person that suggested this. Today I'm reacting to Tomorrow Is Not Guaranteed. Shamsi delivers a beautiful invitation to Islam at Speaker's Corner. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
And they read it out to him to make sure what they've written is correct, okay? But first was preserved in the people's chest. Allah said, بَلْ هُوَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ فِي صُدُورِ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ. The Quran, it is distinct verses within the breast of those who have been given knowledge, okay? And we know that there is many companions at the time Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, and word by word, letter by letter. Rather, like now, which one of the prophecies that I can give you, which is a clear-cut bad date, I mean, it came after the Quran. Allah sent the Quran. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّنَّ الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُذَّكِرٍ. We have made Quran easy to be memorized. Easy to be what? Memorize. This verse is a general verse. Allah never said, I made it easy for the Arabs to memorize it.
When he finishes,
Allah said, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّنَّ الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرِ. We have made Quran easy to be memorized.
So
now,
if it doesn't go off,
Joseph asked this question to many people.
Okay.
There is no book on the earth the size of the Quran. It has been memorized by 100 million of people in Africa, in China, in Europe, in America, by Muslim children. This one you can see it now. So the question, that statement that the Quran has been easy, has been made easy to be memorized, it cannot be a statement of someone lived in the middle of desert. Because in order for me to say my speech or my book will be memorized by everyone, therefore I have to have the knowledge of everyone's memory. You know, and we know that you sometimes you speak to a people who doesn't know how to speak Arabic language, but they memorize the Quran word by word, letter by letter. Rather, Joseph, sometimes they do speak Arabic language, but they will make mistakes in grammar and pronunciation. But with the Quran, they recite it perfectly. For example, Joseph, imagine I'm speaking to you. You give me Shakespeare's poems, yeah? So I'm reading it perfectly. Perfect pronunciation, with the letters, everything. Then you give me English dictionary.
You can't read it.
No, I read as well. Oh, I read it as well, yeah. Okay. But when I start speaking to you normal conversation, I say, me no coming, no, tomorrow, me no going.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Me no, you taking a mic.
Yeah, yeah.
You clearly read Shakespeare's poem perfectly. I gave you English dictionary perfectly with pronunciations. Now when you have a normal conversation, that is a miracle of the Quran, one of the miracles of the Quran. That you see Muslims who doesn't know the Arabic language, they memorize the Quran word by word, letter by letter, and they pronounce it correctly. With the letters, with the vowels, and with the word and everything. That verse, Allah mentioned it way before. And we can observe it right now. What you can do, go to YouTube. Children in Africa memorize the Quran. And you see how from their head.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, my daughter, she's six and she memorized the Quran. Not all of it, some chapters, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
So, that is a prophecy came before.
Yeah, but that's not, I understand where
you're
going. Yeah, yeah, no, I understand that. But that's, the link between those two isn't
strong enough for you.
It's not strong enough, but at the same time.
What do you mean, the link between that?
Let me give you an example.
Go ahead.
Let me give you an example. So today, I prophesize, for example, something's going to happen in a week or a year.
Yeah.
Right? Or maybe I even do a year and then 2 years. I can prophesize many, many things, one after another.
Yeah.
Now, if I was to then know, you could prove to me that when that event happens, that I then predicted it a year ago.
Yeah,
if
I can.
Because
the earliest Quran.
I'll give you an example.
Yeah. The earliest Quran, full Quran, the earliest one, it goes back to the, like for example, that's for the sake of argument, it goes back 700 years before.
700 years before the predictions were made.
What is taking place right now?
Okay.
So clearly before.
Can you give me an example?
No, go. There's a website you can check.
I'm sure you know. You're very smart.
Yeah.
I'm sure you can find them.
No,
on top of your head.
The Quran, for example, okay. There's one in Turkey.
Okay.
There's one in what they call it in Egypt. Full Quran. And backdate some of them even it says backdate Uthman's time, lifetime, which is 1,300 years back. Understand? And again, another example, Sahih Bukhari. The earliest manuscript for Sahih Bukhari, which is, for example, 500 years before, 600 years before, in that Sahih Bukhari, Prophet Muhammad said there will come a time when you see the barefoot Arab man building, competing. So this prophecy, clearly Prophet Muhammad's speech backdated 500 years before. And it's taking place right now. Right. I understand your point, because it doesn't make sense. A prophecy, but the speech came after. That's not prophecy.
Yeah, yeah, that's not
I understand. Yeah. However, with the Quran, the reason being with the Quran was first is recitation. Why? You can change what is on the paper, but you cannot change what is in people's hearts. I can write A, D, F, U. But everyone said, no, A, B, C, D, E, F, you know? But I can change it. And that's the beauty of the Quran, who is preserved in the people's chest. You understand? So there is many prophecies. For example, the earliest manuscript for hadith, this is a refutation against the Christians, missionaries, who say the hadith was written 20 days after. No, the earliest writing, it was by Ali ibn Abi Talib, one of them. One of them was by Sahabi Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As. And one of them, which is we have it now, it was written by Humam ibn Munabbih. Who is Humam ibn Munabbih? He was a student of Abu Huraira. So he would say, Abu Huraira said, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. Okay? And some of them, some prophecies in there. You know, so there's many prophecies Prophet Muhammad ﷺ mentioned way before it's happening now.
Can you give me another prophecy other than the Arab with the two buildings?
I'll give you another one.
Give me another
one. Okay, Prophet Muhammad ﷺ said, it will come a time when you see, of course, an Islam, this is a psych one, but why? You don't like women to be naked? Of course, Islam haram, you forget. But Prophet ﷺ said, from the signs of the hour, women will be dressed but naked at the same time. Mm. Listen carefully, Joseph. Yeah?
I've heard this one.
You know, a person thinking, oh, there's contradiction.
Yeah,
if she's dressed, she cannot be naked.
Yeah.
But what we see now?
Yeah. At the same time. Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? How Prophet Sallam? Yeah. Now I'll give you another one. Prophet Muhammad Sallam said, it will come a time when you see the Arabs stop using the camels as a riding beast, and they will use something as a carrier that will carry them out from their houses with their wives to the mosque. The Arabs, the camel beast is like their family, it's like their mother, they're everything for them. If they don't use the camel as a riding beast, they have to use something else. And we know if you go to Dubai.
But if it's not a horse.
Huh?
Well, no, horse, I'm just playing devil's advocate.
No
I'm
problem.
I'm trying to rule out all
no
the
problem.
You know what I mean?
But horse has a cool carrier.
No, he was saying,
because even the word was called, he was the term was used by Prophet Muhammad sallam, it was a thing that you put on the top of the camel. They will be using something similar to that,
right.
And that will take them, and that you don't put on a horse. Sheikh Al-Albani from your country, he said, may Allah have mercy upon him. He said, it's upon this hadith, clearly the messenger of Allah is speaking about the cars. Because in Dubai, in Qatar, Emirates, Saudi, cars. You understand? So how he knew that again? You understand? And again, Prophet Muhammad mentioned in the hadith, he said, will come a time, or the verse in the Quran. And this verse is so powerful. Wallahi, me myself, this verse increased my belief in Islam to be the truth. Allah said in the Quran, يُرِيدُونَ أَنْ يُطْفِئُوا نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ وَاللَّهُ مُتِمُّ نُورَهُ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْمُشْرِكُونَ. That they want to stop the light of Allah, Islam. And Allah will complete Islam, even if the Islamic haters, disbelievers, hate it. He's the one who sent his Prophet Muhammad with Islam. And Islam will overpower and prevail all other religions. Look, there's many barriers now stopping people to become Muslims. Rather, the network that is against Islam is so powerful for the Muslim to fight against it. But we know the fastest growing religion on the face of the earth is Islam. So the question you ask yourself, who's doing the job? If the Muslims are weak, rather some Muslims are giving bad name about Islam. And I want to use this opportunity to say what happened in Sri Lanka has nothing to do with Islam. Those ISIS are Satan followers. They should not be called Islamic State or a Satanic State, okay? Because it happened today. And they claimed it. And Islam has nothing to do with them. They are a Satanic State. Okay? We go back to the main point. Even though there is many barriers, but Islam is spreading. How could Allah know? How Prophet Muhammad knew that? You ask for another one, I'll give you two extra. So you chef and you believe. So you know that one of the Islam, alhamdulillah, we don't just say to someone, believe. Why I should believe? Just have faith. No. Allah said, He is the one who sent His Prophet with ayat and bayinat, with the proofs and evidences and the signs. You know, that's why when you give da'wah to someone in Islam, you don't tell him, believe Islam is the truth. Why? Because one day I was sleeping and I saw Prophet Muhammad SAW in a dream. So Islam is the truth. You're going to tell me, no, Shamsi, that's your own experience.
Yeah.
That doesn't prove Islam is universal truth. But rather, the Islam, the proof that we have, something called universal truth. Does it make sense to you?
Yeah.
Is it clear to you?
It is clear.
I'm inviting you, forget all of this, because you said if you show me, I will tell you something. Look, Joseph, look, wallah, forget all everyone. Allah mentioned the Quran. يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه لكل امرئ يومئذ شأن يغنيه. Allah speaking about the day of resurrection, the day of judgment, when a person will flee from his mother, from his brother, everyone will say myself, myself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that prepare yourself for the death. You know if an enemy is coming to you, coming to attack you, and he doesn't tell you when he's gonna come, you'll be ready for the enemy any time, correct? Every time you're ready, in case there is an enemy who will come to meet you and meet me, called death. Allah said in the Quran, قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And that shows you the power of Allah. Allah said to Prophet Muhammad, say to them, everyone, the kings, the layman, if you reject Allah and His Messenger, then remember the death will meet you. And the death will surely meet you. And you will return to your Lord. And you will stand before your Lord. Prophet Muhammad said, go visit the graveyard. Why? The graveyard will remind you of the hereafter. And it will tell you about the reality of this life. The graveyard, when you go, those who are inside the graves, there were people like you and me, walking, but today maybe they're not here anymore. As tomorrow. So if the truth is clear to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ ذُكِّرَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ ثُمَّ أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا إِنَّا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُنْتَقِمُونَ. Who is more unjust than the one who's been reminded with Allah's ayat, signs and verses, and he turns away from it, then we will take our revenge from disbelievers. My brother here was telling me, sometimes people say, there is some kuffar, they are good people, so why Allah will punish them? I said, brother, if I take care of my neighbors, but I treat my mother very bad, would you ever call me good man? But hold a minute, I'm taking care of my neighbors though. I'm taking care of my friends. I'm still doing good actions, but because of the evil I'm doing, rejecting my mother and my father and be bad to them, that will overpower my good deeds. Understand? So you don't see my good deeds anymore. So what about the Creator who gave you your father and your mother, who gave you life? If anyone comes with a gun, try to kill us, rather we'll try to defend ourselves or run away. Why? Because the life we have is so dear to us. What about the one who gave it to us for free? That's why, what is Islam? The foundation that I bear witness, no one worthy of worship except Allah. Meaning I should be grateful to Allah. I should be very thankful to Allah who has given me. And I believe that logically speaking, the only way to worship Allah according to his Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, which we have established with the proofs, that is a messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. Understand, Joseph, that is so clear. Forget about people, if it makes sense to you, say openly. Why? Many of us, we used to do evil deeds openly. We didn't care. I drink openly, smoke cigarette openly, flirt with a woman openly. But when it comes to pleasing your Creator openly, say no, the people. The people will not come with you. They will not come with you to the grave. The Messenger of Allah said, when a person will go to the graveyard, meaning when he dies, three things follow him: his family, his wealth, and his actions. Two things will leave him, go back. His wealth and his family will go back. One thing will stay with you, your actions. If it was a good deed, then hayya hala, glad tidings for you. If it was an evil deed, then he will say, the Messenger of Allah said, when a person is an evil man and they're taking him to the graveyard, he say, woe to me, where are you taking me? In this time, because he knows now. Allah said in the Quran, فَلَقَدْ كَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. When death comes to them, and the veil has been exposed, it's been removed, your eyes today is sharp, meaning you know the reality, you see the angels of death. What do you say? The Satan will say, oh Allah, I did not mislead him. He chose to be misled. Understand? So what is stopping me if clear to you? Forget about these people. I bear witness, that is the greatest thing. Allah said, the things that I create for us, that وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created jinn and mankind except to worship me, Joseph. Wallahi, as I've mentioned, if you love your mother with your heart, would you not say it openly? So if you believe the truth and it makes sense to you, because you told me, give me two proofs. One, I gave you two. You see, that is enough. And remember, there is nothing guaranteeing this life except death. We're not ready for death, but death is ready for us. Where is two testimony, which is the greatest thing, and you change your life. Bro, I have people who become Muslim at the age of 14. They're in the videos. 16, 18, 20, why?
I've seen,
When it's truth, understand? Rather, the enemies of the prophets, Allah mentioned about them, they used to mock their followers, the prophet's followers. Why? They used to say they are too quick to accept the truth. Ibn Kathir, one of the Muslim scholars, said, rather that is a praiseworthy for them. Because if the truth is clear to you, therefore logic dictates, you should accept it. But the foolish one, the one who turns away from it. So those followers of the prophets and messengers, they are what? People of logic and common sense. You know? So if you want to repeat it, then alhamdulillah, it's up to you, brother.
Do you know what I want to do?
What you want to do?
You know what I want to do? I want to take a minute, think about what you said.
Okay.
I want to come back here.
Khalas. Today?
No, today.
Okay, inshallah, I'm
today,
here.
I'm going to come speak to you again, but I want to speak to you one-on-one. Maybe privately, maybe...
No problem, brother. Okay, my pleasure. But don't, hopefully, nothing happened to you. Are you guaranteed to come back?
That's no, today? Yeah, I'm here.
You're not guaranteed.
I'm here. Oh, no. I'll tell you a story.
That story happened to me. I was outside the block, my block. This happened. Story happened to me. There's no any person between me and that story.
Yeah.
My neighbor walked past me. Salam alaikum, shaykh. Salam alaikum, salam. Back home, I was young. I was around 13. Salam alaikum, I'm chilling outside my block. My friend came, he said, do you know so-and-so? He was the father of Amir. He said, no, father of Amir. Down the road, I said, yeah. He said, he died.
Whoa.
I said, no, I think you're mixing between people.
Yeah.
I said, the guy will lie, what a lie. I said, you are mixing between the people. I couldn't take it.
Yeah.
Literally, the guy just saw him.
Wallahi,
I just saw him. What happened? Before he opened the door of his house, he was dropped dead. Heart attack. So that's what Allah always, you know, people say, why always Allah threaten people with punishment? Because from human nature, in order for the human to fix up, you need something to threaten them. Even now they know in this country and many countries that they everywhere they put what? CCTV and operation. Because they know the only way for you to stop crimes and to fix up yourself, we have to scare you. You know, that's why Allah always remind you of the punishment, remind them of the death. So if you guarantee to come back, then alhamdulillah. If it's not, brother, if it's clear to you, you want me to, I don't mind me and you go outside now.
Yeah, go now.
Yeah, I want to go now. Yeah, I want to go now. So we don't waste no time.
Cool.
Very interesting. I think I've said this before. Spirituality is a personal thing. Believing is a personal thing. Whether you believe, you don't, you follow, you don't, it's a personal thing. You have to really find why you're following something. Don't just say, okay, I'll follow it, that's when learn about it. At least have a clue of what something is all about. And I love that they had this conversation, and afterwards he asked for a one-on-one conversation with Shamsi, and like the video said, he ended up taking the shahada, or rather saying the shahada, which is very, very amazing. Happy for him. Let me know what you think. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and of course do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video. You.